Welcome to Dr. P.C. Verma Economist YouTube class. In this class, we will examine and try to know different features of New Keynesian economics. There are several models constructed by economists during 1990s and after 2000, year 2000. Several economists are gradually adding to the list of neoclassical economists, but their models differ and many new features are added together. Let us see latest economists who are called New Keynesian economist after year 2000. Number one, Frank S. Smith. Number two, Raphael Altars. Number three, Lawrence J. Cristino. Number four, Martin E. Eichenbaum. Number five, Charles Evans. Before 2000 and during the 1990 years, major New Keynesian economists became popular in the world of economics. Number one, Jordi Galli. Number two, Blanchard. Number three, Mark Zettler. Number four, Nobuhiro Kiyotaki. Number five, Michael Woodford. There are other economists who are also supporting Neo-Keynesian economics, but these names are most widely recognized in the world of economics. In this Neo-Keynesian economics, first feature which I have written, no divine coincidence. The term divine coincidence was coined by Jordi Galli and Blanchard, international economist. They coined this term divine coincidence. Inflation and unemployment, and this feature said, according to Blanchard and Galli, in their models they proved that in Neo-Keynesian economics analysis that in models with more than one market imperfections, for example, frictions in adjusting the employment level as well as the sticky prices, this term adjusting employment level as well as the sticky prices, there is a trade-off between a stabilizing inflation and a stabilizing employment. This is called no divine coincidence. Blanchard and Galli proved that there is no case of divine coincidence in his model. And therefore, they concluded that there is a trade-off between a stabilizing inflation and a stabilizing employment. This was the view during 1990s period of Neo-Keynesian economics. A sticky prices means price remains constant throughout the period of operations in the economy. And adjusting employment level, that employment is adjusted at full employment level or stabilizing employment, unemployment corrections, these are all taken into account while discussing this model by Balchard Gully, who proved that frictions in adjusting the employment level as well as the sticky prices, there is a trade-off between stabilizing inflation and stabilizing employment. We all know that there is a trade-off between inflation and unemployment. Higher unemployment, lower inflation rate. Lower inflation rate, higher unemployment. This has been tested by Phillips curve. And there is also attempt by some economists to develop new Keynesian Phillips curve, which we will discuss later on. Then the second part of the second feature of as we have seen that in neo-Keynesian economics there is addition of many new features after year 2000. Blanchard and Gordy were very much prominent international economists and different aspects were proved, added on the basis of research, empirical study. Second feature of new Keynesian economics is the introduction of imperfectly competitive labor market and model of unionized labor market developed by Blanchard and Kiyotaki, introduced in new Keynesian economics. We all know that perfect competition is accepted in labor market in classical and neoclassical economics. First time in the period of Keynes, he used the term wage rigidity, and thereafter there is development of the role of union, labor union, in the fixation of wages, in the alteration of wages, and therefore research was done by Blanchard and Kiyotaki to examine the impact of unionized labor market upon the wage rigidity and upon the employment and inflation in the economy. Third feature is very important. This is known as Calvo pricing approach. This is also known as the Calvo staggered prices contract model used in new Keynesian economics. In Keynesian economics, new Keynesian economics, price concept is most important because there were issue of price rigidity, there were issue of wage rigidity, and so all in new Keynesian economics, these are on empirical study proved that what will be the impact upon the price variations, price fluctuations, what will be the effect upon the wage fluctuations, and studied by wage fluctuations by through the unionized labor market by Balch, Blanchard and Kiyotaki. Thereafter is Calvo model, Calvo pricing approach. At the Calvo, a staggered prices contract model used in new Keynesian economics, that there will be a staggered price contracts in the analysis of new Keynesian economics related to the introduction of several complex issues in the analysis of price fluctuations versus price rigidity, employment and unemployment concept, wage rigidity. And so Calvo pricing approach, the Calvo staggered prices contract model was used in New Keynesian economics. Features of New Keynesian economics. Fourth feature we have seen here, that is very recent and popular, known as DSGE model. Everywhere you will see in the latest articles, research work in the journal relating to new economics, that is written as DSGE. D for dynamic, S for stochastic, G for general, and E for equilibrium. We all know the concept of Wahlgren's general equilibrium. Partial equilibrium is related to microeconomics by Marshall. And in microeconomics, we read Wahlgren's general equilibrium. But now there is a tendency at global level, general equilibrium is acceptable and developed with the help of use of electronic media, computer, programming, etc. Dynamic means changes with the time. Previously, whenever we discuss things, static models are generally used. Comparative static models are used. But nowadays, there is dynamic model. Stochastic. The term stochastic is related to econometrics. In a stochastic model and in deterministic model, there are two types of model used in economics. Under deterministic model, we are determined that these variables will do the work. For example, capital, for example, labor, for example, technology. We all know the role of these things. But there are many things which we don't know, which suddenly appear, such as coronavirus. This coronavirus is sudden appearance in the economic model. So nowadays, a stochastic term means sudden appearance of any event and disturbing the whole system of the economy. This is known as a stochastic model, a stochastic term. Deterministic is that labor is there, factory is there, factory will open, employment will be there, but one cannot imagine that factory is shut down by the owner, by the state, in the interest of the people, and at the same time workers are retrenched in a gig economy. These are not imagined generally. So there is a term mu in any equation. You might have seen in your Cobb-Douglas production function that Q is equal to lambda L to the power alpha K to the power beta, and mu. Mu is a stochastic term. So in economics nowadays, there is a tendency among the international economists to find out any conclusion related to the general equilibrium. And that is also must be dynamic. That is also must take into account a stochastic variable. So, a stochastic variable is like sudden role of trade union declaring a strike. Government could not imagine, even the private investors, private businessmen could not imagine that this type of thing will appear. And nowadays we are getting recession in our economy, not because of slowdown of the economic factors. This is a biological factors appearing in different international 190 nations, 187 nations are in a grip of this. So this is explained through the stochastic variable. So DSGE, whole world is affected by the stochastic variable, coronavirus. So this is econometrics analysis, which is kept into macroeconomics, discussing dynamic stochastic general equilibrium, which is used to work well with the data and could be used for policy simulations. It is quite complicated, but it is being done with the help of higher efficiency and quality resolutions, computerized finding out the solutions of the variables and constraints in the economy. So dynamic stochastic general equilibrium model will be analyzed that why there is unemployment in Italy, why there is unemployment in Germany, why there is unemployment in Canada, why there is unemployment in USA, why there is shutdown in the factory, electricity is there, workers are there, raw materials are there, why there is shutdown. And then the problem of raw materials not produced in the country, so that is known as lack of vertical discipline, vertical integration in the factory. All factories dependent upon raw material of foreign agents, foreign country, and if there is virus in that country, there will be no supply of raw material. All these stuffs are analyzed in economics under dynamic stochastic general equilibrium model, which is being utilized by Frank Esmet, Raphael Otto, Lawrence Martin, and Charles Evans. And therefore, we have to be taken into consideration that economics is a science. Nobel Prize is given to economists of international repute. So this type of sudden event in the economy, disturbing not only one or two countries, but the 100 plus countries are under it. How can this problem be solved that cannot be analyzed through the static equilibrium model? That requires dynamic, stochastic, general equilibrium model, and where several type of data are used and equations are calculated, and several policy simulations will be developed, which will be followed by the government. In fifth feature, it is mentioned there, habit persistence. This term is very important, habit persistence. This habit persistence is calculated by Facebook, calculated by your biddings, calculated through the Amazon purchasing, Flipkart purchasing, putting into the cards. So such type of new things have developed, and this new habits and the habit persistence, that you buy that because this is in your habit. So in real economics, we cannot avoid habits. On the basis of habits, many forward market, forward looking market planning is done. So in new Keynesian economics, in new Keynesian economics, there are many researches by the international economists which put a habit persistence variable and analyze the effect upon consumption, investment and other behaviors. The marginal utility of consumption depends upon past consumption. Marginal utility of consumption depends upon past consumption. If the past consumption of a product by Amazon is preferred by several millions of people, that it has created a new economics, that they don't produce, they sell. And such a large township of Amazon in Canada, in America, the stocking positions and developing this market, chain market. So this is guided by the marginal utility of consumption depends upon past consumption, that is known as habit persistence. This is the fifth feature of new Keynesian economics to arrive at the conclusion regarding the price stability, regarding the employment stability, regarding the aggregate demand fluctuations in the economy. Sixth feature of new Keynesian economics is monetary policy. Keynes had said that fiscal policy is more stronger and monetary policy is weak. This was his commitment to macroeconomics. And thereafter it was developed in a conflict between monetary policy and fiscal policy. But under new Keynesian economics, they have developed a model that is Taylor rule. That is Taylor rule. We have already discussed Taylor rule in different classes. Taylor rule means monetary policy. Taylor rule has given constant interest rate. And if interest rate is constant, nominal interest rate is constant, then inflation will be constant. So by that research, nowadays, in new Keynesian economics, in place of monetary policy, they use Taylor equations. Taylor equation is one of the equations analyzing the economy under the new Keynesian economics terminology. And seventh feature is adjustments of cost and utilization of capital. Under this feature, it is examined that in new Keynesian economics, capital adjustment cost and variable capital utilization are the common feature which are being utilized in every model. Capital adjustment and variable capital utilization is taken into account. This adjustment of cost and utilization of capital is used in different neoclassical economists in the analysis of the economic policy and design how to cure the economy. This adjustment of cost and utilization of capital term are commonly used in new Keynesian economics. Now we have reached at eighth feature of new Keynesian economics. Every feature is independent topic for discussion and for video formation, but it is impossible to discuss things unless you know the background, that all these are the basis of new Keynesian economics. whenever you discuss New Keynesian economics as a feature, then all points will be discussed. But when you discuss only Taylor's rule, then Taylor's rule will be the main discussion in the New Keynesian economics. It depends upon which type of question is asked in UPSC examination or in project officers examinations, questions are set. All these points are important to be in your kept in your mind, and then you analyze New Keynesian economics even in interview discussing it. So eighth feature of New Keynesian economics is related to new shocks. What is the new shocks? New shocks is known as demand shocks. We all know that in Canada and the USA, long queue of buying groceries in a mart is reported by the newspapers. That is demand shocks. They have never imagined the such type of demand will occur. There is a photo in a newspaper and that all racks are cleared. We are in economics think about how to clear market. And this demand shocks has cleared market just in one day, because there is a demand shocks and there is a fear of that stochastic event that appeared, coronavirus, in all parts of the world globe. Sooner or later, in villages, they are conscious about it. Everyone buying two matchbox, everyone buying two bottles of edible oil. This demand shocks will be in the period of war. If war occurs, then there is a demand shocks. Supplier is always ready to face that. If not, then this opportunity is lost. So in economics nowadays, new shocks, that is demand shocks, which affect the marginal utility of consumption. If they feel that there will not be availability of things, the marginal utility of one gas lighter will be very high. They will take second one, and the marginal utility of consumption will be affected by demand shocks. Next, ninth feature is new shocks, that is markup shocks. We all know that markup is above the marginal cost. Markup is a price fixed by the multinational company, that what is the marginal cost, and if they want to keep marginal cost pricing principle, then they take the price, then add 10% markup. This markup shocks that influence the desired markup of price over marginal cost. In the new Keynesian economics, pricing is related to either cargo staggered prices or through this markup shocks. Markup rule is a method of pricing over and above marginal cost. And 10th feature is Bayesian estimations. Previously in economics, in old Keynesian economics, everything was written, but there was no empirical evidence. And therefore, Keynesian economics was attacked by many economists like Milton Friedman, like Modigliani, many economists who are monetarist economists. They attacked because at that time there was no evidence. For example, Keynes said income is equal to consumption plus saving. and this income is a nominal way he has written. But monetarist economists criticize it and say that which income? Present income or past income? And he developed a model. Milton Friedman developed a model that is known as permanent income hypothesis. Permanent income hypothesis says that this income is permanent, this income is transitory income, sudden income. For example, this time every person who are fighting coronavirus at their stake of life, they will be rewarded by 1 month bonus. Such type of policy framework is now being tested in our country also. So, income, the term which I told you, the income term of Keynes was challenged by Milton Friedman, and this income word is replaced by permanent income. That consumption is a function of income. This was written by Keynes. But the term income was challenged, and by research, empirical work, Milton Friedman proved that consumption is a function of permanent income. He is awarded Nobel Prize in economics. Modigliani, he said that Keynes said income, but he does not say what type of income. And he also criticized permanent income, said that consumption depends upon lifetime income, life cycle income. Person becomes IAS officer, he can have car by mortgage. He can have flat by mortgage. Because his income is fixed for 30 years, it may be calculated, and on that basis mortgage will the facility will be given to the person. Bank officers become PO, and just becoming officer, he can buy a car, he can buy a flat on the basis of his life cycle income. So Modigliani said that life cycle income is the basis of consumption, and he awarded Nobel Prize in economics. So the term income term, which is being tested empirically, and several results came, and several Nobel Prize generated by criticizing economy, by criticizing income, written by Keynes. And likewise, many things which developed by Keynesian economics. And later on, in new economics, many things appears in a new form, more practical, more stochastic, more realistic. And therefore, 10th feature is Bayesian estimation. Bayesian estimation is probability, use of probability in the distribution of economic function. In new Keynesian economics model, Bayesian estimation are very much used. So in the statistics, Bayesian estimation, and in econometrics also, stochastic calculation, stochastic factors used are very much used in new Keynesian economics. Now coming to 11th feature of new Keynesian economics, that is dualisticness. Dualisticness combines a sticky information with sticky prices. Great economist, modern economist, Fisher model, Gregory Mankiw model, Ricardo Riz model, all these models have developed this dual stickiness. We all know that sticky prices means no change in prices. Sticky prices means no change in prices. Even if monetary policy pursued increase in supply of money, there is no such change in prices, that is a sticky prices. And a sticky information, that information is also not frequently received. There is a sticky information model. So dualisticness says that dualisticness combines a sticky information with a sticky prices. This type of model is used by Fisher, Gregory Mankiw, Ricardo Riis, and arrived at the conclusion that there is a fixed probability that you can replan your wages or prices each period. So there is no problem of wage rigidity and price rigidity. It can be solved easily each period by on the basis of fixed probability. Number 12 is a sticky information model. A sticky information model is now becoming very popular because there is a Nobel Prize to the economist dealing with asymmetric information. We all know that asymmetric information is one of the root cause of market failure. Asymmetric information is the root cause of many problems related to the economy. We all discussed perfect competition market where everything is known by buyers and sellers. Such thing of ideal thing. But in reality, in the market, you do not know many things about the product which you are buying. Suppose you are buying a car which is 1 month old, and beside that there is 1 year old, beside that there is 6 month old, then how can you buy that car? You will be in a problem that why the person is willing to sell the car just after 1 month. It may be very much problematic for you to buy that car. And you will ask seller, seller will say that no, I don't know anything about the 1 month old car, why he is willing to sell. This is related to old car selling and Lehman's case. This is called Lehman's market, that you are not knowing everything about the product. So there is a sticky information model, do not have nominal rigidity. Nominal rigidity is also very much important factor in old Keynesian. On the basis of nominal rigidity, Keynes argued that there will be downward wage rigidity during the period of Great Depression, and therefore it cannot be solved by changing wage, lowering wage, that was cited by ACPU as wage cut theory of pricing. Wage cut theory of pricing is most important in neoclassical economist ACPU, who is the greatest critic of Keynesian economics. And therefore, this is explained by nominal rigidity. Trade unions are free to choose different wages and prices. And therefore, these are all related to new Keynesian economics. Its each point will be developed in a form of answer for your UPSC examination or any examinations, budget officers examination, higher grade competitive examination. And you can put all these things wherever you require, wherever you think that is to be used in the conclusion of any theory. That's all. Thank you.